Hello guys, Mr. Malachi TE as usual. In today's video, we'll be dealing with the concatenate function on Microsoft Excel 2016. So the function of concatenate in Microsoft Excel is used to join two text in different cells. Like for example, let's say we want to join the same name Malachi with the name Tshepo in one cell, right? So we want it to be Malachi Tshepo in one cell. So we use the concatenate function to do that. Let's say we don't want to manually type Malachi Tshepo like that, like manually, right? We want to use the function of concatenate to join those two texts. So what we will do is you have to click on equal to and click on the function, right? And you select concatenate. So you have concatenate there. If you can just read on the information down below, you will see that it says it joins several text strings into one text string, right? So okay, we select concatenate, then on text one you place the cursor on top of the first text, you click on it, then you go to text number two, you click on the second text, right? And then you click on enter. So you can see that we have joined the information in one cell. So let's say, for example, now the question comes and say, concatenate the name and the same name in one cell, right? And you have to join those two texts, but with a space between Malachi and Tshepo. So let's see how do we do that. So we go to undo, okay? Then let's click on the function, then we search for concatenate, click on OK. So to creating a space between them, you have to click on the first text, then you go to text 2, okay? Then on the text 2, you don't select on the name. Why? Because you want to create the space between the two text. So you click on shift and then you click at the inverted commas and space, again shift the inverted commas, then you click on text 3. On text 3 is where now you click on the name Tshepo, right? Then you can see that okay, there will be a space there between the two text as shown below. So you can click on enter now. So you can see okay, now there is a space between the two text. Then let's say, for example, you want to do the same for Murutwa somewhere there, but now you don't want to go to function and do the same thing again. So what you can do is just go to copy, go to home and copy, right? And then you highlight that until the last person. So in this example, we will just be using those four people, rather five people at the top there. And yeah, so let's say we want to do the same for the following persons, but we don't want to go to function and do the same like we did for the first one. So you can click on the first one, go to copy and click on home again and click on paste the function. So you can see now that okay, those people, you did the same for Murutwa Samuel, Mabe James, until Mwatse Franz, right? So that's how we do the concatenate function. Then again, okay, let's say we want to do the same for those, but we don't want to go to home and go to copy and whatever. There's a shortcut for that. So let's just go to undo and I will show you the shortcut for that. So firstly we have to select okay do for formalize table. Okay, we can go to function, select concatenate, then we select the first text. We want to create space, remember? Then the second text, then enter. And remember, it depends on the information that is available to you, whether to create the space between the two text or what. So pay careful attention to that. Then you can go to the corner of that cell, and you can see now that the cross now changes to be a little bit slighter, right? Then you click on the left. You left click on your mouse, and you hold your left button on your mouse. Then you scroll down until the last person, and you can see now that you copy that using what the using the shortcut, right? So yeah, that is how you do concatenate. Then how do you filter information? Filtering information, you go to home tab, then there is filter there, and then you can select filter. And why do we filter information? We filter information so that it can return a specific information that you want, right? Let's say for example on the exam mark, we want those to only show the students with a mark above 75, right? So you will select on the exam mark, and then you will go to select all and select that. Then you go to Seventy-five. You can select those. You can manually do that, or you can will use another method you will see shortly. Then you select on OK. Then you can see now that we have filtered the information to show only the people with a mark of 75 and above, right? And then we can filter again. Using let's go to select all of them, and then we get our original information like it was. So you can do that because selecting one by one is a little bit long or a tough work. So you can go to you can sort from smallest to largest. You can sort from largest to smallest. Yeah, then you can go to number filters. Then you go to custom filter, right? Then on the custom filter, you will okay. The remember we want the information, or we want the students only with the mark of 75 and above, right? So you can click on 75% there or greater than 75%. So you can click on OK. It seems we have did a mistake there. Okay. So we go to custom filter. Okay, exam mark that equals. Oh, okay. So we can see that we have selected AND instead of OR, right? 75. Right. There it reflects only the students with a mark of 75% or above. So that's how you use the concatenate function and the filter, and how that's how you filter the information. So subscribe to my YouTube channel for more beneficial videos. Thank you.